All right, let's get a look at those October numbers for Aurora. So like my other videos, what we're going to have a look at, we're going to have a look at the most current month we have in the Toronto Real Estate Board stats, which is October 2021. We'll have a look at what happened a year ago in Aurora in October 2020, and then we'll also have a peek at what happened in September 2021, just to give you a bit of contrast. Now, if we're talking about the numbers, the number of new listings that came to market represented by the N a year ago in Aurora was 177, and that is across all home types, so condos, semi, towns, links, detached. The number of sales represented by the S was 137, and the active listings that carried over into November 2020 was 192. New listings came to market in September was 143. You had 84 sales through the month in September. Active listings were 88. So again, I've mentioned this in a couple videos. We're definitely seeing, you know, you can see now what the media has been talking about, in that the amount of active listings hanging around, and you'll see it other, you know, in other places in the stats, you know, definitely this whole year has been a little bit more of a contraction of the market, which has been making it, it's required a little bit more aggression to buy a home. And certainly as a seller, it's been a pretty great year. In October, new listings that came to market, 130, so a bit of a contraction there from the month before, 112 sales. Now, this is a trend that we've been seeing in some other markets as well, that we did see less listings come to market in October over September, and we saw the buying trend actually ramp up a bit. So not shocking that we did see September be a little bit sluggish. I mean, it had been the first month that kind of popped up in the number of sales coming to market, which is normal for September because we do have kids getting back to school, and you know, this year, you know, notwithstanding, but we had, you know, a few things going on. And so people were kind of getting back to quote unquote normal, if you will. You know, less listings through October. And again, when you look at places like Newmarket, you're also seeing that the buying trend picked up a little bit, and the active listings actually are contracting a little bit as well, which is adding to that heat. If we're talking about the money, $1,054,000 was the average sale price across all home types a year ago in Aurora. In September, $1,405,000. October 2021, we're looking at $1,415,000. And if you remember my video from last month, you were in like the 1.1, 1.2 range, you know, of August. And then, you know, we had like a $300,000 increase in a month. And that trend has actually continued into October. The SNLR, one of my favorite stats, it's known as the sales to new listings ratio, could also be referred to as the absorption rate. It tells us, out of the homes coming on the market each month, what is the percentage that are actually selling? And the reason it is one of my favorite stats is because it can really gauge where, as a buyer or seller, the market is at for you and whether it's a time to act. And so, you know, if we look at the stats of 0 to 100, if you are 0 to 50, that would be indicative of what we would have as a buyer's market. Between 50 and 60 is what's considered a balanced market. So there's enough supply to meet demand. And then when you get over 60, certainly when you're in these numbers, you're into a seller's market. So 77.4% of the homes that came on the market a year ago in Aurora sold. 58.7 in September. So again, bear in mind that inventory levels climbed up from the month previous. So that's going to add to this number depending on where the buying is. And in this case, in September, buying had stayed fairly on par. I'm going off my mind here, but fairly on par with what it did the month before. Now we're into 86%. So you have less listings coming to market. You know, sales ramped up pretty significantly, and also the active listings, which carry over, like they're essentially what didn't sell, they've reduced. So I would almost, you know, argue what we're seeing is, you know, we're seeing, you know, less listings, we're seeing the sales ramp up, this is less. So I would suggest that a few of the buyers at least have circled back to these and chewed up a little bit of these active listings. So you're seeing 86.2%. Now, months of inventory remaining kind of goes hand in hand with the absorption rate. Tells us that if no other homes came on the market after today at the current rate of consumption or the current rate of buying, how long would it take to completely deplete the inventory? So 1.4 months of inventory in October 2020, 1 month of inventory in September, and we saw a further contraction in October to 0.7. Sale price to list price ratio, 99.5% of asking in October 2020, 104.9 and in September, and currently trending at 107.4. Now, days on market to get a home sold, 20 days a year ago, 18 in September, currently trending at 11. So again, not shocked to see this stark reduction, again, because the buying trend came up so quick and or came up so much. And then what we're seeing is an increase in the sales to new listings ratio, which would tell us that the homes that were being sold or the buyers that were participating fairly aggressively. So certainly this year there has been a trend towards underpricing a home to the market, which always does reflect in this number. It maybe doesn't give it a, it always, I want to say it's a bit of a disruptor for the, for the, what this actual number would be in a normal market. But certainly the trend has been towards, getting many eyes on a listing and the cultivating of more than one offer. So, I hope you found this information helpful. If you have any questions on any of the information I shared here or how it would pertain to your specific home in Aurora, I would love to hear from you. Feel free to reach out.